So when UNICAT started building expedition vehicles, which is a couple of decades back, we mainly used Unimog chassis, Mercedes-Benz Unimog chassis, which is very well known as the best off-road vehicle. And the Mercedes engineers always said that the Unimog has a flexible frame, that the chassis can twist a lot, and they claimed, and it's true, that this is a big advantage, because with a frame that can twist, you can stay much longer on ground with all wheels, and only when you are on ground with all wheels, you can safely drive in off-road conditions. So, with a torsion frame of the Unimog, Mercedes also introduced the three-point subframe to allow the mounting of a body on that chassis without getting all this chassis torsion into the body. So that the torsion-free subframe, or a so-called three-point subframe, is not something very new or something that we invented. No, Mercedes put it in their literature that if you want to mount a body on a Unimog chassis, you have to use a three-point subframe. So we did that. We used the Mercedes systems, and we actually modified it after a while, just to get the body a little bit lower, closer to the chassis, to save overall height, to get the center of gravity down, stuff like that. Okay, then when we started building expedition vehicles based on truck chassis, we asked ourselves the question, how does torsion work with the truck chassis? Because as much as the Mercedes people said, the Unimog chassis is flexible, the truck manufacturers said, the truck chassis is stiff, it's very solid, nothing is moving. But when you look at the chassis itself, when you compare a Unimog chassis and a truck chassis, they are very similar. Both have U sections as main parts of the frame, and they have cross members, the back and further forward. They look different. Some cross members are round on the Unimog, some cross members are made of sheet metal, but that principally doesn't make a big difference. Okay, so what we actually did with the first truck we got, we asked the manufacturer, how much does the chassis twist? And they couldn't give us any information. Well, at least they didn't give us any information. So we just tried to find out ourselves, was that we have put the truck diagonal on pedestals. So here we have put up the right front wheel, and on the other side we have put up the rear left wheel. So this simulates driving through uneven terrain, which is considered to be off-road. And that's a situation where you will create twist in the chassis if there is any twist. And as you can see now, this pedestal is going up, and it's even lifting up the rear wheel. And if I do the same on the other side with this device here, then you can see that there is some twist in the chassis. So, and that's only 40 centimeters on each side, while in real off-road, you can actually manage much more. Okay, let's have a look from the rear of the chassis so you can better see the twist in the chassis. So now, when you look at the driver's cab and when you look at the frame end, you see that there's a huge angle in between. And actually, the driver's cab is following the front end of the frame, while the rear end you can directly see. So all the angle between the driver's cab and the rear end is twist in the chassis. And this twist is happening even without having a body or any load on the chassis. So now imagine that the body is solidly mounted on this chassis. What will happen? One part is that the body will twist as well. And if you twist the body, then you will have damages in the body because the body is a very solid box, at least should be a very solid box. And if you twist a box, it will break. And everything inside, especially furniture, will break as well. The other thing is that when the box is built quite solid, it will also hold the chassis and reduce the twist of the chassis. And if you have less twist on the chassis, you have less off-road capability. I will show you why. Okay, now with this situation, with the front wheel up and the rear wheels down, we already are in a situation where we can't really properly drive in off-road because this wheel is no longer on the ground. So now if the chassis would twist even more, this wheel would come further down and it would be on the ground. So if you lift your wheels up and you have a lot of flex in the chassis, then all your wheels will stay on the ground very long. And that's a real big advantage. And that's why Mercedes Unimog people say we design a flexible frame so all the wheels stay on the ground for a long time. But principally, the same thing happens on truck chassis as well. So here is another interesting view of the chassis twist. We have put a white tape on the one frame section and a yellow tape on the other section. And if you go down a little bit with the view, you will see that in this area, the chassis is now quite horizontal, while in the rear, it's bending to the right side. And in the front, it obviously does the opposite. Okay, so there are many, many details you have to look after when you install anything on the chassis. You have to keep the clearance everywhere, and you have to make sure you don't fasten it in too many places. And one good example for the people who are building the vehicles themselves is this one. So when you look at the chassis, at the frame here, it's standing like this. The same profile at the front, standing like this. And over the length of the rail, it's going more and more and more and more into the other direction. And when you, for example, install a fuel tank, when the chassis is on the even ground, the brackets on which the tank is sitting will be perfectly parallel. But once the chassis starts twisting, they go out of balance. So one of the brackets will be higher than the other one. obviously. And as fuel tank is a very solid box, like an expedition body, if you try to twist the tank will break. And that's why if you want to install a large tank, you should not have the brackets too far apart, because the level difference between the brackets when the chassis is twisting will become that much that it will break your tank. Now, that was a chassis without a body. Now we have here a vehicle with a body on the chassis. This actually is a 4x4 and it has 5.1 meter wheelbase, so it's a pretty long wheelbase. And the longer the wheelbase is, the more twist you have in the chassis, which you can already see quite well here. Again, the driver's cab is following the front end of the frame where it's mounted, and the body is following the bearing of the mounting system, which is, at least in our case, installed close to the rear axle. Now, with the lift of only 20 centimeters diagonal, which is like 8 inches, you see how much twist you generate in the chassis, which is very well visible here between the driver's cab and the body. This is only 20 centimeters lift on each side. That's really not a lot. Actually, the subframe has to be built in a way so that you can lift up the vehicle as much it can lift, so that one of the wheels is free in the air. If one of the wheels is free in the air, it won't twist any further, but until then, all the system has to do it. So let me lift up this one here at the rear end. So you see that that the twist is more and more, especially you see between the driver's cab and the body. And now I also lift it at the front end. Don't worry, it won't break apart. Okay, good. So, what you can see now is that the chassis is really a lot twisted. But that's good, because the truck is still with all four wheels on the ground. And so you can still drive off-road. You also see that, you see this gap, which normally is parallel, now it's a V, because all the brackets are following the chassis, the rail, where it's mounted at. And you can also see, if you have a look inside here, so this is one of the pivoting parts of the subframe. You see that here it's much higher than on the other side. So what we do here is we allow the weight forces to go into the frame. We allow or we take care of the lateral forces, but we are not transferring any torsion from the chassis into the body. So the body is a rectangular box as it's built and as it should stay forever. But that's only possible if you have a proper built three-point subframe. And imagine if you do a system with springs that can lift up, you will still have forces, because you need forces to compress the spring. With this system, there are no forces in that direction. Also, on this side here, you have a fuel tank. And now the distance between the filler cap and the floor of the body is only like 3 inches left in this situation. Yeah? And this will become less and less the more the chassis is twisting. But the twist we have now is not the limit of the truck. It's just limited by the equipment we have here. But you could probably lift it up another 20 centimeters, so that high from ground, before one of the wheels would be in the air. And that extra lift would then reduce that distance. So when you install tanks, when you install equipment, you have to keep clearance to make sure nothing is colliding and breaking, actually. While other stuff like storage boxes, which are mounted at the body, they just go with the body. Of course, you have to have clearance between the frame and the box on the inside. You also have to have clearance between the underride guard and the box, which is now closer on the other side. So there is quite a lot to think about. And experience helps. And we learned it within 30 years. And I think that's for now. We see us in the live chat, and I'm happy to answer your questions. Thank you.